Alrighty guys, welcome back to this next little video where we're going to be doing something kind of different today. So I've been working full-time now for about 3 weeks, and I really haven't been putting a whole lot of effort into actual content for the channel simply because I've been so busy. But today I want to show you what I've been working on in the background. As you can see in my background. I wanted to show you though what I built with very little money and a whole lot of passion. Let's get into it. Okay, so let's just go over what I actually have. As you can see, well, let's start off by first talking about the blatant thing, or the most obvious thing, the desk. The desk is an old, just plywood desk or wooden desk that I got off of Facebook Marketplace for like 20 bucks about 5 years ago. It's been running, or it's been doing good for me for so long that I just have no reason to change it out. As you can see by this, this is my RGB controller. This controls the RGB behind the desk, while I have another RGB controller that controls the RGB behind the monitor. And you'll be able to see the RGB better when I do some better B-roll. Alright, so for monitors, these are two 5x4 aspect ratio 1280 by 1024p Dell, like, professional grade monitors. They're from 2015, they're ran by DisplayPorts, and they are IPS 75Hz panels, or, well, they're IPS that I clocked up to 75Hz because these things say that they shouldn't be, but they easily can be overclocked to 75Hz in the bio or in the tuning utility, and it absolutely no problem. My third panel is my third Dell IPS panel. This is from the same series as these two, but this one is my 1600 by 900p monitor that I have clocked down, or I have resolution down to 1440 by 900p. That is running at 75Hz. For some reason, these monitors do not like doing 1600 by 900 by, or at 75Hz, but 1440 by 900 or 1440 by 900 at 75 works perfectly fine. So that's where that comes from. Keyboard wise, I've got my bloody B975. Now, what makes this keyboard kind of cool? See if you can actually see these where it's actually in a focus. Well, my camera doesn't want to focus on it real well, but if you guys recognize these, those are the same optical switches on the new Razer Huntsman keyboards. Because Bloody did it about 5 years ago. Whoops, I have that on wrong. These are the clicky variations, which I know some people don't like, but I genuinely really, really like the way they sound and the way they move. So, yes, I love this keyboard. And I love the Bloody brand. I know it's kind of weird. They're like A4 tech, and they're more common, like, from my understanding, in like Indonesia and other parts of Asia. But in the United States, they really only have one reputation, and that was some guy made a video about how CSGO players cheat on LAN events, and he used the Bloody Gaming logo and Bloody Gaming essentially as, like, I don't want to say slanderous, but essentially talked about how they were used, or they could be used for cheating on LAN. Which, I mean, you can do that with literally any programmable mouse and keyboard, so Bloody is not the, like, brand to go with if you're looking for cheating. Which I do not condone, by the way, seriously. Don't cheat. And then for keyboard, or for mouse, I've got my, what is this, my V7MA. This is an older variation of their V7s, but, I mean, I love this thing. I have the TL50 Terminator as well, that I use as my side mouse, because I'm just more comfortable on this style of mouse. Not too heavy, not too light. It's probably more heavy than what most people would consider to be good nowadays, but I still love it. Just got this basic pad that I had gotten from, I don't even remember, just a random keyboard. SteelSeries mouse pad. And you guys all know my tower. That's my X5680, 48 gigabytes of RAM, R9290. Same exact setup that I've been running now for a while. And I'm still rocking the same specs. I haven't changed anything about the tower, and I don't plan to change it for at least a little while. But we might do something different with the cooling in this case. But that'll be coming. Still got the front mod RGB lights. So these normally were like more of a bluish, and now they're more of like a sky blue to match the rest of the theme. Just got some basic wallpapers that I took some random wallpaper and then edited it to make it more look my style. Got all my boxes on my wall and movie collection and other such collections. And now for the kind of more fun thing. Now, don't critique me on my cable management too much, but as you can see here, secondary light strip, primary light strip down there, and then this is my monitor arm with my three displays on it, which looks really good in my opinion. Oh, and there's, I guess, two more little things that I need to add here. This is my Akio AK80 microphone, the one that I use for all of my recordings. Now, this microphone is, yet again, I think this thing's probably about 8 years old. I don't remember exactly when I got it, but I've had it for a very long time and only recently started using it. It's a wonderful microphone. It goes into the same category as like the newer, the newer NW700. It's very similar to that, and I actually have an NW700, which I really can't differentiate the differences between these two microphones all too well. Red boom arm. I should not have gotten red. I should have gotten black to make it go with the rest of my theme, but I'm just kind of sitting here with the red one for now just because I have it, and I'm going to be getting another one soon, but that's just kind of here for now. And then, yeah, you guys remember how I kind of said that I'm an audiophile? This is my, put the serial number up there because I forget what this is, but it is a Logitech surround sound, 5.1 surround sound with subwoofer audio setup. Now I only have the front left and front right currently running. I want to mount a center one behind this monitor and have it like be vertical, kind of pointed up. And then on this side, you can see the actual subwoofer. Now this is kind of like its own little echo chamber. It doesn't have the best acoustics, and I understand that. And I know I really should have it in a better spot, but that's the only convenient place that I could have it because I simply don't have any room on my desk with a triple monitor setup. And I'm not putting my tower on the floor because I'm just not going to do that. Oh, by the way, this is also the, the controller interface that I plug my headphones into. And this is my headphone of choice. Beat Mixers. I'm just that extra. Like, I don't know why I'm such a bass head, but my Beat Mixers running through the full like sound system that's going through my audio card, it sounds amazing. Like, this motherboard has absolutely garbage built-in audio, and now you guys can kind of get the idea of why I like was so harping on that thing when I first got it, because this is an actual proper audio setup, and this is my full setup. The speakers that I got, I actually found at a thrift store for 25 bucks because I didn't know if they worked or not. These two monitors I got for $16 a piece. This monitor I got for 40. The boom arm I got for, I want to say 19. The microphone I got for 19. Fans, well, I could do like a whole thing for my PC. I'm not going to go through all the parts, but that honestly wasn't all that expensive, all things considered. And then my desk I got for 20 bucks. And the RGB lights, another 40 bucks. This is what I've built. This is my gaming setup. And honestly, I love it. I don't know what to say about it. It's just fun. But thank you very much for watching. I will see you guys later. Have a good one. And oh, by the way, this does not look like an X58 CPU now, does it? Catch you guys in the next one, where we're gonna have some real fun. See you later. Peace.